This is KASM Radio Broadcast. Kingdom Aimed Forever Media. It's time for the weekly Church Bible Hour Roundup.
I woke up this morning feeling fine. I woke up with heaven on my mind. I woke up with joy in my soul, 'cause I knew my Lord had control. Walking in the light, 'cause I'd been on my knees in the night, and I prayed till the Lord gave a sign, and now I'm feeling mighty fine.
Oh, well, I'm feeling mighty fine. I've got heaven on my mind. Oh, don't you know,
I want to go
where the mill can't honey flow. Down inside this heart of mine,
I've got heaven on my mind,
and I'm feeling mighty fine.
Yes, I'm feeling fine. I've been walking with Jesus all the time.
I hope that everyone has had a wonderful week. It is great to be back here again for another hour to spend together, renewing our minds on the Word of God together and singing to God. And I do pray that this is a blessing to you. So why don't we launch this off with a song and a prayer of thankfulness and gratitude to our wonderful God.
We thank Thee each morning for a newborn day, where we may work the fields of new-mown hay. We thank Thee for the sunshine and the air that we breathe, O Lord. We thank Thee. Thank Thee for the rivers that run all day. Thank Thee for the little birds that sing along the way. Thank Thee for the trees and the deep blue sea, O Lord. We thank Thee. Oh yes, we thank Thee, Lord, for every flower that blooms, birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank Thee every day as we kneel and pray, that we were born with eyes to see these things. Thank Thee for the fields where the clover is grown. Thank Thee for the pastures where cattle may roam. thank thee for thy love so pure and free, O Lord, we thank thee. Oh yes, we thank thee, Lord, for every flower that blooms, birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank thee every day as we kneel and pray that we were born with eyes to see these things. Yes, we thank thee for the fields where the clover is grown. Thank thee for the pastures where cattle may roam. Thank thee for thy love so pure and so free, O Lord, we thank thee.
Well, as we spend this hour together, we're going to open up the phone lines now so we can receive your calls, your request, as well as we can have a discussion about heaven and what you think will be in heaven. What are those beautiful things, those beautiful objects that will make up heaven? What will be there? What will we enjoy? I so look forward to hearing this, to hearing your calls, to being able to play what you would like to hear, some of your favorite hymns, and being able to discuss with you what will be in heaven. This is KAFM Radio Broadcast.
I come to the garden alone while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on
tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.
He speaks, and the sound of his voice is so sweet, the birds hush their singing, and the melody that he gave to me within my heart is ringing.
And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own. The joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.
Okay, let's go to those phones and receive our first call. This is KAFM Radio Broadcast. Who are you, and what would you like to hear?
Hi. My name is Baby Hanny Williamson. I'd like to hear Peace By and By.
Well, we can do that for you, Hannah, but why don't you tell me first, what do you think's going to be in heaven?
I think in heaven, there's going to be a boarding house and hunting and older, lots of people. And everyone will listen to God, and there will be lots of candy, and...
Well, there you have it, folks, straight from Hannah. Heaven will have a boarding house with lots of people and lots of candy as we listen to God. Well, let's listen to this one for Baby Hanny, Sweet By and By.
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there in the sweet.
And this is the Sunday Review. Well, beloved, tonight we're going to be looking at Ephesians chapter 2. And as Ephesians chapter 1 built off the love of God, this is going to continue in building a doctrine, a rich theology on the working of God and what He has done for us, in us. You see, we were once dead in our trespasses and our sins, meaning we walked not by the life of God and who He is, not by the Spirit of God. We did not walk by the power of God or the ways of God, but we walked by the ways and the patterns of this world. But in Christ Jesus, we were quickened, given life, and we were made to die in the ways of sin, and to live in the ways of Christ. Now, this is not a means of our working or doing anything. It's nothing that we can boast about. So our living in Christ is not a work of ourselves. It is something that has been accomplished by Christ. It is the work of Christ, the death on the cross, where He says, "It is finished." He accomplished His work that we are made alive in. And the first evidence of our life being made alive in that completed work is that He rose again from the dead. That completed work of Christ that we are made alive in. And in that same work, our sins were put to death. Made alive, and sins put to death. For what purpose? Unto what is He doing? He is building a holy temple. He is assembling a people to Himself. And this is a truth, a spiritual truth and reality that we must not forsake, that we must not abandon. The assembling of the church. We have a representation of it every week, a physical representation by the grace of God, and we do not bend, we do not abandon it. It is the assembling, no more than we would abandon or forsake the blessed faith that He is calling us each to Himself, and that there is a reality to that blessed, eternal assembling together in Christ Jesus. Of course, the Greek word for church means the assembly. We are the assembled, those who are being assembled together. And Ephesians 2 is going to hit on this. Because we were once dead in our trespasses, but in Christ we have been made alive in Him, in His work. And the good works which we have and which have been accomplished and which we have been made alive in and have been made to sit in heavenly places together in Him. Right now, in Him. And that calling out, that assembling together, that fitting together of which Christ is the chief cornerstone, that is what makes up the church. And so, yes, absolutely, the buildings are not the church, but the assembling together of the children of God is the earthly representation of the church. It is in reality the assembling. Before heaven and earth, when we come together as brothers and sisters in the Lord, we are the assembling, the church, with Christ and in the presence of Him, we are. If heaven is your highest priority, if heaven be your aim, if heaven be the truth that you most celebrate, then let the church, the assembly, assemble. And let this assembly be the richest of times and seasons known to you as you walk this journey. Ephesians chapter 2. And you hath He quickened, who were dead in trespasses and sins, where in time past you walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience, among who also we all had our conversation in past times in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for His great love wherewith He loved us, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace ye are saved, and hath raised us up together, and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in ages to come He might show the exceeding riches of His grace, in His kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. Wherefore, remember that you, being in time past Gentiles in the flesh, who are all called uncircumcision by that which is called the uncircumcision in the flesh by the hands, that at the time you were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. But now, in Christ Jesus, you who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. For He is our peace, who hath made both one, and hath broken down the middle wall of partition between us, having abolished in His flesh the enmity, even the law of commandments contained in the ordinances, for to make in Himself of twain one new man, so making peace. And that He might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereby, and came and preached peace to you who were far off, and to them that were nigh. For through Him we both have access by one Spirit unto the Father. Now therefore, you are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints of the household of God, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom all the building fitly framed together groweth unto holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also are builded together for a habitation of God through the Spirit.
Kingdom Aim Forever Media.
Someday he's coming back for me, and then his face I'll see. What glory that will be eternally. So until then, I watch and pray, wait patiently the day when I shall hear him say, my child, well done. The Bible says he'll come again to catch his bride.
Well, back to the phone lines now. Tell me, who are you? What would you like to hear? And what are your thoughts on heaven?
My name is Macy Jane Williamson. I would like to hear Bringing in the Sheaves. Thank you. Bye.
Well, hold on, Macy. Don't go anywhere yet, honey. We want to hear about heaven.
I think in heaven that God will be everywhere. And his love will cover everything, and no bad things will happen.
Sowing in the morning, sowing seeds of kindness, sowing in the noontide and the dewy eve, waiting for the harvest and the time of reaping, we shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves.
Sowing in the sunshine, sowing in the shadows,
fearing neither clouds nor winter's chilling breeze.
That's fine singing.
By and by the harvest and the labor ended, we shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves.
Everybody join us.
Bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves. Going forth with weeping, sowing for the Master, though the loss sustained our spirit often grieves. When our weeping's over, he will bid us welcome. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. We shall come rejoicing, bringing in the sheaves. sheaves.
This is KAFM Radio Broadcast.
And so this is now the part of our time together when we get to go back to the sermon, the book that was done by Jonathan Edwards, Heaven, A World of Love. And this evening we'll be looking at the second part, The Objects of Love That Heaven Contains. And here I would observe three things. First, there are none but lovely objects in heaven. No offensive or unlovely or polluted person or thing is to be seen there. There is nothing there that is wicked or unholy. There shall in no wise enter into it anything that defileth, neither whatsoever worketh abomination. Revelation 21, verse 27. And there is nothing that is deformed with any natural or moral deformity. But everything is beautiful to behold and amiable and excellent in itself. The God that dwells and gloriously manifests himself there is infinitely lovely, gloriously lovely as a heavenly Father, as a divine Redeemer, and as a holy sanctifier. All the persons that belong to the blessed society of heaven are lovely. The father of the family is lovely, and so are all his children. The head of the body, lovely, and so are all of the members. Among the angels, there are none that are unlovely, for they are all holy, and no evil angels are permitted to infest heaven as they do this world. But they are kept forever at a distance by that great gulf which is between them and the glorious world of love. And among all the company of the saints, there are no unlovely persons. There are no false professors or hypocrites there, none that pretend to be saints, and yet are of an unchristian and hateful spirit or behavior, as is often the case in this world. None whose gold has not been purified from its dross, none who are not lovely in themselves and to others. There is no one object there to give offense, or at any time to give occasion for any passion or emotion of hatred or dislike, but every object there shall draw forth love forever and ever. Secondly, they shall be not just lovely, but perfectly lovely. There are many things in this world that in the general are lovely, but yet are not perfectly free from that which is the contrary. There are spots on the sun, and so there are many men that are most amiable and worthy to be loved, who yet are not without some things that are offensive and unlovely. Often there is in good men some defect or disposition or character or conduct that mars the excellence of what otherwise would seem most amiable. And even the very best of men are, on earth, imperfect. But it is not so in heaven. There shall be no pollution or deformity or offensive defect of any kind seen in any person or thing. But everyone shall be perfectly pure and perfectly lovely in heaven. That blessed world shall be perfectly bright, without any darkness, perfectly fair, without any spot, perfectly clear, without any cloud. No moral or natural defect shall ever enter there, and there nothing will be seen that is sinful or weak or foolish, nothing the nature or aspect of which is coarse or displeasing, or that can offend the most refined taste or the most delicate eye. In that blessed place, no string shall vibrate out of tune to cause any jar in the harmony of the music of heaven, and no note be such as to make discord in the anthems of the saints and angels. The great God who so fully manifests himself there is perfect with an absolute and infinite perfection. the Son of God, who is a brightness of the Father's glory, appears there in the fullness of his glory, without that garb of outward lowliness in which he appeared in this world. The Holy Spirit shall there be poured forth with perfect richness and sweetness, as a pure river of the water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding out of the throne of God and of the Lamb. And every member of that holy and blessed society shall be without any stain of sin or imperfection or weakness or impropriety or blemish of any kind. The whole church, ransomed and purified, shall there be presented to Christ as a bride, clothed in a fine linen, clean and white, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing. Wherever the inhabitants of that blessed world shall turn their eyes, they shall see nothing but dignity and beauty and glory. The most impressive and stately cities on earth, however magnificent their buildings, yet have their foundations in the dust, and their streets dirty and defiled, and made to be trodden underfoot. But the very streets of this heavenly city are pure gold, like the transparent glass, and its foundations are precious stones, and its gates are pearls. Revelation 21. And all these are but faint emblems of the purity and perfectness of those that dwell therein. Thirdly, and in heaven shall be all those objects that the saints have set their hearts upon and which they have loved above all things while in this world. There they will find those things that appeared most lovely to them while they dwelt on earth, the things that met the approval of their judgments and captivated their affections, and drew away their souls from the most dear and pleasant of earthly objects. There they will find those things that were their delight here below, and on which they rejoiced to meditate, and with a sweet contemplation of which their minds were often entertained. There too they shall readily find the things which they chose for their portion, and which were so dear to them that they were ready for the sake of them to undergo the severest sufferings, and to forsake even father and mother and family and friends and wife and children and life itself. All the truly great and good and the pure and holy and excellent from this world, and it may be from every part of the universe, are constantly tending towards heaven. As the streams tend toward the ocean, so all these are tending to the great ocean of infinite purity and bliss. The progress of time does not but bear them on to its blessedness, and us, if we are holy, to be united to them. Every gem which death rudely tears away from us here is a glorious jewel forever shining there. Every Christian friend that goes before us from this world is a ransom spirit waiting to welcome us in heaven. There will be the infant of days that we have lost below, through grace to be found above. There the Christian father and mother and wife and child, and friend, with whom we shall renew the holy fellowship of the saints, which was interrupted by death here, but shall be commenced again in the upper sanctuary, and then shall never end. There we shall have companionship with the patriarchs and fathers and saints of the Old and New Testaments, and those of whom the world was not worthy, with whom on earth we were only conversant by faith. And there, above all, we shall enjoy and dwell with God the Father, whom we have loved with all our hearts on earth, and with Jesus Christ, our beloved Savior, who has always been to us the chief among 10,000s. and altogether lovely. And with the Holy Spirit, our sanctifier and guide and comforter, and shall be filled with all the fullness of the Godhead forever.
This is KAFM Radio Broadcast.
Many years ago, in days of childhood, I used to play till evening shadows come. Then winding down an old familiar pathway, I'd hear my mother call at set of sun. Come home, it's supper time. The shadows lengthen past. Come home, it's supper time. We're going home at last.
Some of the fondest memories of my childhood were woven around supper time, when my mother used to call from the back steps of the old home place, "Come on home now, son, it's supper time." Oh, gee, but I'd love to hear that again. But you know, for me, time has woven the realization of a truth that's even more thrilling. And that's when the call comes from the portals of glory to come home where it's supper time. When all of God's children shall gather round the table with the Lord himself at the greatest supper time of them all.
Come home, it's supper time. The shadows lengthen past. Come home, it's supper time. We're going home at last.
Kingdom AIM Forever Media. This is KAFM Radio Broadcast.
All right, now let's head back to the phone lines. And who do we have with us now?
Hi, my name is Aaron Williamson.
Why, hello, Aaron. And tell me, what are your thoughts on what heaven's going to be like? What's going to be in heaven?
I think we'll be in heaven. Well, when you first get there, it'll be so the light will be blinding and you can't see. And then when you can see, it'll be so beautiful that anything on earth will look like nothing. And all the people who believe in God will be there, and you'll meet them, and God will be everywhere and in every place.
Wow, that's what a wonderful thought, Aaron. And what would you like to hear tonight?
I would like you to play, please, Were You There?
That's great, and what a great time of year to play that song. We can definitely play that for you tonight. Here it is, Were You There?
This is KAFM Radio Broadcast.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Were you there?
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Were you there?
Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Were you there?
Were you there
when they nailed him to the tree.
Were you there?
Were you there when they nailed him to the tree?
Were you
there? Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb?
Were you there
when they laid him in the tomb?
Sometimes
it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they laid him in the tomb?
Share. tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling for you and for me. See on the portals, he's waiting and watching. Watching for you and for me. Come home, come home. Ye who are weary, come home.
KAFM Radio Broadcast.
I called on the Master. I said, Lord, help me to pray. For I'm that little black sheep that you've been hunting today. I thought I could wander, find my way all alone. Now I want you to guide this rolling stone. Then I heard his answer so clear to me. Tell again what I learned at mother's knee. Now I thank the Master for starting my life anew. Just ask and he'll do the same, my friend, for you.
I thought I could walk,
find my way all alone.
Now I want you to guide this growing stone.
Then I heard his answer so clear to me. Tell again what I at mother's knee. Now I thank the Master for starting my life anew. Just ask and he'll do the same, my friend, for you.
God be with you till we meet again. By his counsel's guide uphold you. With his sheep securely fold you. God be with you till we meet. Till we meet. protecting hide you. Daily manna still provide you. God be with you till we meet again.
This is KAFM Radio Broadcast. See you Sunday.